You make a difference, Buzz, to those who I feel are doing something special or kind. I wanted to make a button like that, honoring the 40 years that this chapter of the Crohn's and Colitis Foundation has been making a difference. I'd now like to welcome a San Diego board member, past honoree, and a champion of the foundation, Gori Conagetti. It is now my pleasure to introduce an incredible brother and sister duo. They have a very special relationship with our chapter, and I'll let them tell you their story. I am pleased to introduce our 2022 Champions of Hope Gala co-chairs, Dr. Ann Barrett-Lauder and John Roseman. Ann, also known as Vara, is a member of our San Diego board and is our new board president.
How proud are you?
Very.
We're all going to get to know Mason a little bit better. Hello, Mason.
Michael.
First of all, thank you for being such an amazing MC tonight, right? Incredible MC. Yes.
Thank you very much.
And you yourself are an amazing IBD champion and warrior. So I just want the audience to know a little bit more about you, and I'm going to learn some things too, I think. So,
okay.
I want to start by asking if you can share what your involvement is with local politics and the restroom access bill specifically.
So it started when I realized people with medical issues in California could be turned away from restrooms. So my mom and I met with the senator, asked for people to write letters about when they had been denied the use of the bathroom. I made a video to show what we go through, and then we wrote up a bill the way we wanted it. And it almost took a year of ups and downs before the bill was passed. The bill was AB 1632, the Restroom Access Act, ensures that people with certain medical conditions have access to employee-only restrooms when a public one is unavailable. I'm so proud to be part of making this bill pass in California, so nobody has to be anxious or nervous to leave their home.
We appreciate it. That's an amazing accomplishment. And, thank you for advocating. It's a very important bill, and we appreciate all your effort.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. So we also know that you have been charitable in a lot of ways for a long time and inspirational to a lot of people, but what inspires you to give to others?
I think it is important to recognize kindness and to help others. My parents have always supported me and helped me figure out ways to do this. When I was younger, maybe 6 or 7, I thought it would be nice to surprise someone doing something nice and say thank you. So I bought gift cards at Starbucks, put candy in them, put candy in the bags, attached a note that said, "You make a difference." Then whenever I caught someone doing something kind, it could be anything like even offering a smile, I would surprise them. Around the same age, we were eating dinner at a restaurant and they were doing a fundraiser for St. Jude's. I asked my parents if we had a local hospital for sick kids, and they told me about RAIDS. I asked where families would stay if their child was sick in the hospital, and they told me about the Ronald McDonald House. I wanted to help, so we started doing 2 drives a year, and would host good karma stands where we would hand out free homemade treats to say thank you to those who donated. That is also where Good Karma Candles began. Then I was diagnosed with Crohn's disease, and I really wanted to help find ways to raise awareness about this disease.
Amazing. And you're still doing that, right? This is still happening today?
So, the candles, the books, we haven't really been able to do the drives because of some of the donations might come in and I'm immunocompromised, so we have to be more careful.
Of course.
But we haven't been able to do it lately. It's been more busy, but we're still doing the candles, which helped donate, and some of the books.
Excellent. Amazing. Thank you. So Mason is also a published author. Yeah, that's right. You heard me correctly. So can you tell me a little bit more about your book?
So the idea to write a book started when I was diagnosed with Crohn's, but I didn't feel ready to illustrate a book. This summer, I took a class with Story Experiential with Pixar. I learned to storyboard and drew a lot of illustrations. The story was based on my drawings of food when I was on gut rest in the hospital and really hungry. I created a character, Reggie, a slice of pizza, and told my story through him. My mom thought the timing was perfect to finally write a children's book, and I thought it sounded fun but challenging. So my mom offered to write a book, with me, and we could use all of my illustrations from the class. I enjoyed working with my mom on it, and we hoped the story might help others going through chronic illnesses and create awareness in a creative and humorous way. There's a copy of my autographed book at each table, and whoever has their next birthday gets to take my book home. Consider it an Earth Day birthday present. Early birthday present.
Thank you. That's very generous. Really kind. And all the lucky winners. So the last thing I would love for you to share is just tell people tonight about your journey with IBD.
So growing up, I was always healthy and hardly ever got sick. So when I was diagnosed with Crohn's disease, it was really upsetting because I just wanted to feel normal like I used to. I also did not like shots, and that's how the treatments for this disease are given. When they told me I would have to do treatments for the rest of my life and that there was no cure, I cried. I actually cried. Dr. Bauman was the one who told me, and she was really kind about it. I have met so many good doctors at Rady's, and I love my GIs, Dr. Bauman and Dr. Wong. Mm-hmm. And also, Nurse Robin. She always gives me my injections, and I rate them 5 stars. She's such a good Everyone in the GI clinic is so welcoming. The nurses at the infusion center are also really kind, and all the doctors and nurses feel like family. My therapist, Jeannie Foss, is also part of that extended family. And I've been so excited to meet Dr. Polk tonight because I've heard a lot of incredible things about him.
That's true. Thank you so much. It's so great to get to know you better. We look forward to your next book, to all the ways that you're going to impact this community and so many others. So thank you for everything you're doing.
Thank you.
Appreciate it myself.
Woo!
Yeah, round of applause for Mason.
Absolutely. I'm really proud to work at Prometheus, and our founder is Cedar Sinai. Dr. Yamada, Dr. Sanborn, Dr. Targan, they laid the foundation for what's to come. I speak tonight for the members of the team in the trenches, doing the hard work in the lab and the clinic to make better medicines available for IBD patients. We get up every morning excited by the idea that our work may be the very best hope for patients like Mason to achieve long-term remission. Over the past 2 years, I've gotten to know this amazing young man. And I'm just in awe at how you've battled through this. And through your parents, how they've led as well. I've been associated with the foundation and the IBD community since 2016. And I've witnessed firsthand the debilitating effects of this disease and the hardship this places on patients. I committed back then to make a difference in the lives of these patients through significant investments in research and development, clinical trials, patient resources. We are making significant headway towards the very next step.
Raise funds for those with IBD. Please join me in welcoming Franco Finn to the stage.
Woo!
Mason. Oh my gosh, give me a high five. Give a round of applause to Mason, everybody, by the way. You're awesome. Reminds me of me when I was a little kid right there at 13 when I started getting on the mic. So you got a promising future, my friend. My name is...
As you heard earlier from Mason, California didn't have a restroom access act. After almost a In writing this book, our hope is that not your average slice of pizza will create empathy, bring comfort, and continue to raise awareness. These goals were important because I remember feeling powerless against this disease. I couldn't promise Mason he would be cured or that he would feel normal again. For the first time as a mother, I had people stepping in and telling me what would happen to my son. I was reduced to a bystander with little understanding of this disease. I realized that if I had these feelings, my son must have them far worse. There had to be a way to help Mason feel empowered with his diagnosis. It would take a lot of love, activism, thinking outside the box, a good sense of humor, and being brave. We taught him that heroes exist, but you can always be your own hero. Mason is my hero, and I have learned so much about his strength, courage, and ability to keep a sense of humor in all of this. I'm so proud of him, and he knows his father and I will always be by his side in this fight. Even while fighting his own battle with this disease, Mason has discovered there is healing he found in helping and advocating for those who battle silently. I belong to support groups where I see the victories, the devastation, the pain, the interruption of lives, the loss of work, and the stealing of time. This disease not only attacks the patient, but the entire family. And in it all, they look to the heroes that are not giving up on them. Heroes like each of you who have taken the time to be here tonight. Every single one of you took action just by being here, and you will be part of changing the life. This disease is known as an invisible disease, but with events like this, that's changing. Mason is getting stronger every day, thanks to biologics and treatments that research has provided. It is also thanks to his care team at Rady's, who we are thrilled to have with us tonight. Mason's success is also because of fundraisers like this one. Doctors who fight for their patients, scientists who never give up, volunteers who generously donate their time, and the company standing here tonight for providing and pursuing treatments. This is why supporting the Crohn's and Colitis Foundation is so important. Each time we fall apart, we put ourselves back together again, a little stronger than we were before. Thank you for being part of the glue that holds IBD families together and gives us so much hope. Thank you for hearing my son has to say, for taking action, and letting him know he has value, and most of all, that he and so many others who suffer from IBD deserve better treatments and care. Thank you